Hey guys, Joe Kistel here. Recently, I did an underwater shoot for National Geographic focusing on the invasive lionfish epidemic. This footage you see here is from my professional underwater equipment, but I also used some GoPro equipment in this package.
Yummy.
And as you can see the diver here, I actually put a GoPro on him. And here is a GoPro footage from this diver's perspective. And most people think like, wow, that looks pretty good for GoPro footage and wanted to know how I made it look like that. So I'm gonna try to explain that as simply as I can here today. Here's what the footage looks like out of the camera. In this case, we're at 100 and so feet here and makes the footage look green like this, pretty crusty, and we don't want it to look like that. So there's a few things we need to do here. First things first, I'm using the software Adobe Premier. I'm gonna use a few tools and a few effects to achieve the result that I want. First thing I wanna do is change my view. So I go up to Window, go to Workspace, and go to Color Correction. And in Color Correction here, I'm gonna use our tools over here. And first thing I'm going to do is I want to get my YC waveform. Go over here, hit the drop down, and hit YC waveform. Real quick introduction to this. What this tool does is it allows me to determine if my footage is exposed properly. Basically, I want my highlights up here near 100 and my shadows down here near 0. So this would be your highlights, this would be your shadows, and obviously I'm not exposed correctly because I'm not near 100 or 0. So I need to change that. So what I'm gonna do is go over to my effects here. I'm gonna go to Video Effects, Color Correction, and go to Luma Curve. Now that I double clicked, Luma Curve will be under my effects here. This adjusts my highlights, and this adjusts my shadows. Okay, so I want my highlights to be up closer to 100, so to do that, I take this and go over, get it just under 100 in this case, that's probably good. And I'm gonna bring my shadows down to 0. Okay, the resulting footage up here still looks pretty crappy. Let's get a better frame. But in theory, that's better exposure. What we did here is when you turn it on and off, we basically made it a little more contrasty, but it still looks like horse poop. So now I wanna adjust the color. To do that, I wanna go to RGB Parade. And what this kind of shows me is the balances of colors, so to speak. In this case, they're all over the place. So we want those to really match if we want it to look kind of like a natural daylight situation. I'm gonna make some adjustments to try to change that. And to do that, I gotta pull another effect. The effect I like to use for this is RGB Curves. Double click on it, that means it's applied. And here it is, now we need to make some adjustments. This works similar to the Luma Curve. These are highs and lows, but it's each color channel. So we can obviously see we have way too much green. So I'm gonna take my green highlights and I'm going to drop those. Okay. And I'll drop my green lows just a hair as well. Okay. Now we wanna bring our reds way up. Okay. It's too much, my computer's a little jumpy, sorry. A little bit more, probably about there. And here you can kind of see what we did here. It's definitely better. Now, in my case, I like a little bit more blue in my underwater shots. So I'm going to bring the highlights of my blues up just a hair. Bring that down. And I'm gonna bring up my red shadows too. And so anyway, that's kind of it in a nutshell. You can see we're a lot closer than we were, and when I turn it off, that's what it looks like. And when you turn it back on, that's what it looks like. Now, the last thing I'm going to do is, since I've made some strong adjustments into my exposure, I'll probably have to apply some saturation. So I'm gonna go to Effects, down to Fast Color Corrector in this case. Double click it, it's applied. Scroll down to find it. Here it is, I don't touch any of this. All I'm gonna do is go down here to saturation, do 130%. And then that made a subtle difference, but you can see it. Okay, we'll go with that. So this is kind of our before and after. So you can see we definitely made some changes. Again, this is GoPro footage, so there's some limitations to what we can do, but this made my footage match a little bit closer to what came out of the good camera. It's not the same as the good camera, but it's closer than what it was. So that's what we end up with. Hope this was helpful. If it was, please consider subscribing. And thanks again. I'm Joe Kistel.